Okay, we are finally getting out of here, which is undeniably one of the worst hotel rooms I've ever stayed in my life. Don't know what she's doing in the back there. I think she's very excited. You know why? Because we're going to Rome! We're finally going to Rome! We have been here in this little town for like 6 days. It's been lovely seeing family and stuff, but it's been very full on, and isn't it exciting just to finally get to Rome? Yeah, it's been too long, yeah. All right, we're getting a cab. We're going to get there, and we'll be in Rome in about an hour's time, so... Okay, we have arrived at this beautiful hotel here in Rome. This place is amazing. We have working Wi-Fi here. It's nice, it's clean. So much better than the last place we're at. I'm gonna really enjoy this. But we do not have the time right now to sit around in this hotel. The cleaner's still in here actually cleaning. We do not have enough time right now to stay in this hotel when we can be out in the beautiful city of, we're gonna go out and explore Rome, because when you're in Rome, you've got to spend as much time in the city as possible. Yes! We made it to Roma! Ciao Roma! Standing right in front of the Pantheon. Absolutely wonderful piece of architecture, just like everything here in Rome. All this ancient architecture is incredible. This would have been an absolute beauty in its time. This whole thing was covered in marble when it was originally built. And then later generations stripped it of the marble and used it in other buildings and other things. It's just so sad how that's happened. It's fantastic. The hotel is just down the corner there. It's like 2 doors away from the Pantheon. Right in the heart of Rome. Oh, love this city so much. One of my favorite cities in the world. Gonna wander around today and just have a look at some of the sights, and I'm just busting to... It's her first time in Rome. She lives over this side of the world. 2-hour plane ride here to Rome, and you've never been. This is my second time here. I've been here more than you. Roma! Fontana di Trevi. Okay, that's gonna be our first stop. This is one of my favorite places in the world, Alicia. The Fountain of Trevi. Fontana di Trevi. We're heading to the Trevi Fountain now. One of my favorite statue pieces, sort of fountains in the world. I absolutely love it. So we're heading there now. That's our first stop here in Rome. When you're in Rome, it's almost impossible not to be able to find the Fountain of Trevi, because there are signs absolutely everywhere. And funnily enough, they're actually McDonald's signs. So you follow the signs to the McDonald's and you get to the fountain. Don't follow the signs to the McDonald's to get to the McDonald's, because it's the worst McDonald's I've ever had in my life. But it's also one of the only public toilets here. So if you're after a toilet while you're in Rome, go to the McDonald's. When you're in Rome, you'll notice that there's sort of a juxtaposition in the type of architecture that's here. There's sort of this, which is more modern in comparison to something like this. I'm not gonna put a date on this, probably 100 years old, but this kind of thing, thousands of years old. And it's just all over the place. No matter where you look, you've got this juxtaposition of the new and the old. This would have been covered in marble at one point as well. Just imagine what Rome would have looked like back in the day. Oh, mamma, mamma, mamma. There it is, that's what I was telling you about. McDonald's, which means we're not too far from the Trevi Fountain, as I said. And here we are at the Trevi Fountain. You're gonna see one wonderful piece of, mama. Here it is. Oh, I can't believe this. This is gorgeous. This is one of my favorite landmarks in the world. One incredible, incredible human feat. I'm so excited, we're getting really close to this. Oh man, I have to say, last time we were here was when they were doing the renovations. It was 2 years ago, they were renovating the fountain. They had plexiglass up everywhere, just up the top of these steps here. That's about as far back as you could get. This is the thing that I was most excited about coming to see. And I was so disappointed when it was just all blocked off. We couldn't get in. You could barely see it. You had to look through it through this plexiglass. They gave it a big clean out because it got really dirty. They spent months and months cleaning it out. They drained it. They cleaned the floor and they cleaned all the statues. And we're here when they were all working on it. They had all these people up on scaffolding and everything up there. I don't know if you've ever seen in my videos, but I have a picture of it on my desk. Just, I look at it every day and go, gee, I just hope I can see the Trevi Fountain with water in it one day. And it's, oh, it is a gorgeous sight. One of the best places on earth, right here. I love this. It's beautiful. Look at this. We're walking down now. Oh, this is so exciting because obviously I've never been this close. I can appreciate it so much more now that I'm actually able to get up close to it and not in, you know, behind a piece of plexiglass. You loving it?
Yeah.
She's loving it too. Look, hang on, turn around. Yes, Trevi Fountain! It's a tradition here at the Trevi Fountain that you have to throw a coin into the fountain. You throw it over your shoulder and that means you will always return to Rome. Thousands of them down there. I wonder who cleans up on all that money in the end. Alright, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, count three. Uno, dos, tres. We'll be back. We'll be back in Rome one day. It is so hot. It's over 30 degrees again here. It's insane. You're boiling. I'm just going to admire this fountain for a little bit longer and then we're going to move on and see some more sights. I'm loving it so far. Oh, Roma. Mwah, bella. Real gelati. Woo! Incredible gelatis, although they cost €8 each in the end. I think it's because we decided to sit outside and eat. In Rome, you pay for the view, basically. €8 a gelati? That's basically 16 Australian dollars for a gelati. It's about 4 o'clock here. We've got the best part of a day left to go and see stuff. You can see pretty much everything you want to see in Rome in a day. This whole area is just all these old ruins, all old excavated ruins down here. This whole strip. It's really, really awesome to see. It's really fantastic. What the work they've done here and the cultural integrity they have to preserve all of this stuff is amazing. It's a country that's, you know, got thousands of years worth of history attached to it. And seeing stuff like this is just mind-boggling, especially when you're coming here for the first time, because we just don't have history like this in Australia. The entire strip is just like walking through footprints in history. These guys don't have a head. Romans. Alright, we come up to one of the most exciting parts in Rome, especially for a first time visitor to this wonderful country. Are you ready? She has seen it straight through there. We've come to it. That's the biggest smile I've seen on her face all day. Magnificent beast of a building. This is the Colosseum. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful building this is. Like I keep saying, architecture of ancient Rome was just incredible. You don't see buildings like this anymore. Stunning. And then over there you've got that arch. I'm not too sure what that one's called. I've forgotten. It's sort of, it looks like the Arc de Triomphe in France, but that's not it, obviously, because we're in Italy. It, too, is also a very famous arch, of which the name I have forgotten. So we'll call it the Arc de Triomphe of Italia. This is the older portion of the Colosseum, the inner wall. And then that's the section where they've done most of the renovations on it. They renovated it at one point to sort of bring it back to how it would have looked. And then they've left a whole chunk of it sort of as it looked after they excavated it. So you get sort of a look at a bit of both. I believe this also would have originally been covered in marble when it was originally built and then just pillaged at some point, which is a real shame because it would have been beautiful. And this, I dare say, would have been covered in marble as well. It would have been a marble arch. How does it feel to be standing in front of one of the most famous buildings in the whole world?
Amazing.
She is loving this. We're around the back of the Colosseum now. This is the section you don't really ever see on TV or anything. Actually, last time we were here, we didn't come around the back, so it's pretty cool to see this this separate section here. As I said back there, this whole thing was at one point covered in marble. Just imagine how gorgeous that would have looked years and years after these kinds of things went into disuse. The emperors of the time ordered their servants and ordered the people to go and pillage all these old buildings of their marble, and they used them in their palazzos, in their palaces, for their own personal use. You know, those people just had no respect for their history and just the gorgeous buildings and structures that they have here. I mean, in hindsight, you know, thousands of years later, you kind of look back and you go, you idiots, absolute idiots, because this thing would have been absolutely gorgeous. I mean, it is, it's gorgeous it is, but just imagine that in its prime. Oof. So we're sort of coming back around to the front part of the Colosseum now, so I think this is the point where we sort of just move on. That's the Forum there. It's miraculous. It's like an entire town that they've excavated down there. There's a church, there's like a theater, there's housing district, everything. This whole city of Rome was built on top of the ancient city. So as you can see, there's the two levels that we're walking on, and then a level down there, which is all the ancient ruins. So this whole city is on top of ruins. They've only excavated, you know, a certain percentage of it, but what has been excavated is really, really miraculous. We're now walking down the Spanish Steps. We're ticking off all of the major landmarks here in Rome on our first day. Like I said before, you can do that in a day. It's really beautiful. So there they are, the Spanish Steps right there. We've just walked down them. Another one of the great sights in Rome, and this little fountain thing that's at the bottom of the steps, of course. Very cool. From memory, I think there is a Disney store somewhere down that way. So we're gonna hit that up later in the week and I'll do another vlog in that Disney store like the one I did in London. It's a smaller store there. Obviously the one in London's the biggest Disney store in Europe, but this one's actually, from memory, a very small store. I'm not gonna spend a heap of time in there like the last one because all the products are basically the same, but it's designed really, really nice. It's a really beautiful store. So we will go down there and do a special vlog from the Disney store here in Rome. It's gonna be awesome. Okay, we're gonna go on the move again because it's getting late. One more thing we wanna check out and then we're gonna end the night and end the vlog. So let's get moving. Here it is, right there. Yes, we'll definitely be coming back to this one. Very cool, very, very cool. Why not?
Well, you can't pretend like you're avoiding the camera.
Yeah, you can.
Everywhere.
Yeah, that's the point. Don't break the fourth wall. Of course, we couldn't finish the vlog without returning back to this masterpiece at night time when it's all lit up and it looks absolutely gorgeous. I love this thing so much. I got myself a little watermelon drink. Very nice. It's still very hot. Okay, we're gonna end today's vlog by throwing a coin to the fan. This time we've got proper Euros, but we're gonna throw in, not Australian, 50 cent coins. So you ready? Uno, dos, tres. Woo! All right, that's a perfect way to end the vlog, I think. Right here in front of the Trevi Fountain in Roma. It's been a great day, isn't it? A wonderful day. As always, if you are a new viewer to my channel and you've liked what you've seen, you'd like to see some more, please, after the jump, hit subscribe. I am in Europe for about another month and a half, so plenty more of these Euro vlogs 2017 to come. To all my regular viewers out there, thank you once again for joining me. I hope you've been enjoying my Euro vlogs. Tabs with everybody out there. Take care. I hope I'll see you again soon. Until next time though, guys, take care and I hope you have a magical day. Ciao. She said yes! Not her. This one over here. This one over here. She said yes. Woo! Oh. Oh. Woo! Woo! Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful? What a way to end the vlog. Bellissimo, yes! She said yes! Oh. Okay, ciao guys. Ciao. Another one of the things I love about Rome, you've got these random water fountains everywhere, sticking out of walls, sticking out of just random columns, sticking out of what looks like sewerage. Some of them look like they're even like for horse troughs, but they're drinking water and people actually come here and fill up the drink bottles with this water. It is so clean, it is so pure and amazing, this water. You can drink it straight off the side of the street and you'd never guess it. It looks like sewerage, but there's a tip, you can do that while you're in Rome. Although, maybe I wouldn't be drinking from that one there. Homeless guy washing his hair. Avoid that one. That guy obviously didn't see. And now he's gonna have a drink. Ugh.